Good morning, Shane, and thanks for joining us here. I know you're getting ready to go fishing and all that, but man, good to see you even in this changed world. Just wanted to congratulate you on your 2020 summer you had up there, you know, out in Hawaii, as winning that division with 2,100 points. You had a great summer.
Yeah, we're lucky. We had a consistent year for a change. Usually we're more of the sporadic type where we do really well in one or two and then you don't hear from us for a little bit. So it was nice to be consistent for a change.
How did you get involved in fishing, and you know, what is your current operation?
I got lucky. I had an easy in. My dad is Fran O'Brien. He's been fishing in Kona for a long time, I would say since the late 70s professionally, but been coming over to Kona with my grandfather since he was a little kid, 12 years old. So I was lucky. I had him as an in, and I grew up fishing with him and his friends, and I had an easy introduction to everybody. Even traveling around the world, I'd be in Cabo walking the docks, and I'd tell somebody I'm from Kona, and they would ask if I know Fran O'Brien. So it was very easy to connect the dots around the world and get the jobs and do what I had to do. And now I got linked up with a guy named Alan Stewart, who's just the greatest guy to work for, and I've been with him since I was 18 years old. So we've had a good run so far.
Yeah, and the boat you're on, I see the Wild Hooker, but you also take care of the other boat, right? You have two boats.
Yeah, so this was the first boat that Alan had and this was the first boat that I got a job running, and it was the Strong Persuader. It's a 43 Merit over in Hawaii, the old five star. So I worked on this boat, and he had this boat for probably 4 years, I guess, before he purchased the 61 Wild Hooker, which we no longer have, but now he has a 68 Blackwell called the Wild Hooker as well. So those are the two that I'm on most of the time.
In November, you just recently came back from fishing over there in Bisbee's, but tell people a little bit of how that boat made a journey.
The boat was in Cabo for 2 years after being in the Gulf of Mexico for 3 or 4 years. So it was in Cabo for 2 years, and we decided to bring it back to Hawaii to try and fish some of the stuff that we're unable to fish on the 43 Merit, you know, around the other islands that get really rough around the east side, south side of this island, and potentially even do seamount trips or northwestern Hawaiian island trips. So we brought back the bigger boat to try and do some of that stuff. And then it started getting close to Bisbee's time, and we realized that we wanted to compete down there. You hate to not participate in $4.5 million worth of winnings. So we started looking for a boat to charter, and we just couldn't find one that suited our needs and for a price that was reasonable. So Mark Schubert, the guy that works with us for the last 3 years, said that he'd be willing to drive the boat back to California. And so he definitely stepped up for that, and it's pretty cool. So we had him, we got a guy named Guy Williger and Greg Hopkins from over here in Hawaii, and they delivered the boat from Honolulu to California, so 2,400 miles. And they did it safely in 12 and a half days, and everything went great. And from there, Charlie and I flew in, and then Charlie and I and Mark took the boat from San Diego down to Cabo, and we just got done fishing the tournaments down there.
Yeah, what a shame no one got to stick a big one. But
yeah, kind of crazy, first time in 40 years nobody weighs one.
Yeah, and how was the scene there for you guys this year? I mean, obviously with COVID.
It was quieter than normal as far as the town goes and everything like that, but the turnout was great. The amount of money being spent and gambled was great. You know, they have that Chupacabra Challenge, which is a $20,000 a day bet, so a total of 60. There were 9 boats in that, more than ever. So with all the Costa Rica boats coming up and everybody itching to compete, it seemed like there was a real good turnout, so that part was fun. But the fishing for the big Bisbees was just not up to par.
So, yeah, well, hopefully next year it'll be you know, bigger and better. I'm sure it just happens to be one of those years, but
yeah, it seems like it's one of those years.
yeah. And Shane, you know, being from Kona and fishing Kona and such a magical place, How has Hawaii fishing has it changed recently? I mean, if somebody hasn't been out in a while, are they gonna, you know, is it? I mean, tell me a little bit about it, you know, currently.
As long as I've been doing it here, it feels to be pretty much the same. The only thing that's been on a bit of a drought the last 4 or 5 years have been the granders, which, you know, normally there's one or two a year on average, and there has been none this year so far. There was only one last year and none the 3 years prior to that. So it's that's a little strange. That's a little abnormal. But as far as the numbers of fish, been great. And last year there was a ton of small ones. I mean, more than normal. And this year it was great fishing as well. So everything else seemed normal. Just the fish that are, you know, the real big ones don't seem to be being caught, whether they're here or not, whether people are missing them and just not working out. But that's been the only change that I've seen in the last 4 or 5 years.
You know, a lot of lure fishing. I know a little bit of dredge activity, but as far as technique.
A lot of lure fishing. A lot of guys, a lot more boats over here are going to dredges. And I don't know why that is. I think just, you know, a lot more guys are getting two crews and things like that to make it a little easier. And there's a lot more private boats that where money is not so much of an option. You know, before out here, every dollar counted. And so dredge fishing can be expensive. With the LPs and everything to operate them, it can be expensive. So a lot of guys never did it. But now that there's a lot more private operations, guys are switching over and doing everything they can to be competitive and catch more. Yeah. So you see a lot more dredges happening now. And we do a little bit of it. We back and forth, just depending on what we got going on. But everything we did last year was pretty much trolling all lure fish.
What was the biggest one you caught this summer, you think?
The only fish we weighed was a 671 this summer. And that was the biggest one we saw during the tournaments, I'd say. So we were lucky to catch that one. And the rest were all under 300 during tournaments.
Yeah. So what'd that fish come up on, and what'd she eat, and what happened?
That thing ate a small Koyanagi to Eric Koyanagi. So we've been using most of all of his lures, Koya or Kerwin. So you know Kerwin real well, and he makes some beautiful custom lures. So, and we love him to death, but we try and stay loyal to our two guys. So really, Koya and Kerwin, whatever they make, we'll put out. But that fish we caught on a Koya tube, a smaller tube. It's actually an 8-inch lure. That one was just a regular Yozuri black back skirt.
You know, we had a previous conversation. You're starting to kind of explore other areas around Kona, and you know, what are your goals there, and what are you looking forward to?
That's what's exciting, actually. So I'm hoping that we're going to do a brief shipyard visit, hopefully, with the other boat in San Diego here this month and next month, and then I'm hoping to get the boat back over to Hawaii, you know, just after the first of the year, so we can start doing a lot more South Point trips and volcano side of the island trips. There's so much territory over here that nobody fishes. I mean, just because it's rough, you know, it's rough, it's far. And a lot of times you don't need to. A lot of times you can go right out front in the calm. And so there's no advantage to going far. But myself and Alan, who owns the boat, and Charlie and Mark, we're all super adventurous. So we want to go do new stuff, not just the same old thing every day. So there is some fantastic fishing that there's really no reports on. I mean, if some guys fishing commercially, they'll catch tunas, bottom fish, things like that, but nobody's ever put any amount of time in marlin fishing. So that's what we want to do. And even just get the fish up further in the Hawaiian island chain, Kauai, Niihau. There's another rock that comes out of the water called Kahula Rock. And we're also working on trying to get some permits to do satellite tagging up in the northwestern Hawaiian islands. You know, we won't be able to kill anything or anything like that, which is fine. We're trying to do some more research and just explore up there. So, you know, originally we had talked about wanting to go to the South Pacific and do it down there, which at some point we might, but for now the Hawaiian Islands have more than we can explore even in a lifetime. So yeah. We're going to start here. We're going to start in our backyard.
Man, that's great. Yeah. We'll have to, keep up with all that, advancements, and, man, we just wish you well. And I know you got to go fishing this morning, but man, it's good to see you. And gosh, I hope we can do something, come out there, bring the cup out, and have a little party together.
Yeah, I hope so. That'd be great. You know, let me know when. I'll let you know when all of our regulations out here lighten up a little bit, and it'd be good to have everybody out here. We'll go fishing and hang out.
And that's one last point, just as far as regulations. I guess what do you need? A 72-hour negative test to visit, and
Yeah, so that's where we're at now. You just need a test to come in, and if you have a negative test, they'll do the instant test at the airport as well when you land. Even if you do have a test prior to coming out here, they get the results in 15 minutes, and once you have that, then you're good to go. No quarantine, no nothing. Free to go wherever you want. So that's given us a little boost in tourism here lately. I think they said last week in Kona we had 1,000 new incoming arriving passengers, so that'll help the economy. So it's good to see, rather than a mandatory 2-week quarantine.
Yeah, and I know the charter boats need help out there too. So the fish are there. I mean, Kona's, there's fish there every month, so it's not like they're not.
That's it. It's November, and we're going out on a half day with some friends of ours. So I'll let you know how we do. But you can catch them any time of the year. So really, the more people we get out here, the better.